Hello students, welcome back to this video. In the last video we have seen the chapter integers. In that chapter we have seen the definition of whole numbers, natural numbers and integers, and one more thing, properties of addition, that is closure property, commutative property and associative property. Properties of subtraction. In that we have seen the closure property, only the closure property hold in subtraction, and the commutative property and associative property does not hold for subtraction. Next thing is additive identity and inverse. In that we have seen the zero is the additive identity and the opposite number of the number is the additive inverse of that number. That means if we have to find the additive inverse of plus 5, then minus 5 will be the additive inverse. Now in this video we will see the properties of multiplication. Same as addition and subtraction, we will see the closure property, commutative property and associative property. In closure property, if a and b are two integers, then a multiplication b is also an integer. For example, see the example is given 6 and 7. Both the numbers are integers. Now after taking their multiplication, that means 6 multiplied by 7, you will get the answer 42. Is 42 a integer? Yes, 42 is an integer. That means it is close under multiplication. Now see the next example. Minus 3 and minus 2, both the integers. If you take the multiplication of that integers, you will get the answer plus 6. And plus 6 is also an integer. That means if we take two integers, then their multiplication is also an integer. This property is called closure property. Then second property is commutative property. In commutative property, we will take two integers, that means a and b, and after taking two integers we multiply both the integers by each other by interchanging their position. That means a multiply by b and b multiply by a, and we will see the answer is same or not. If the answer is same, then that property is called commutative property, and commutative property holds in multiplication, so their multiplication should be equal. That means for example, if we take 2 and 3, then take their multiplication 2 multiply by 3, you will get the answer 6. That means if you multiply 2 with 3 or 3 with 2, you will get the same answer. That means it is commutative under multiplication. The next property is associative property. In associative property, we have to take three integers. That means a, b and c are any three integers. Then a multiply by in bracket b multiply by c is equals to multiplication a with b in bracket, it is multiplied by c. That means both the answers will be same. If we multiply first number with second and after that we multiply that number with third, or multiply second with third and the answer with first, you will get the same answer. See the example. 1 multiply by in bracket 2 multiply by 3 is equals to bracket 1 multiply by 2 multiply by 3. You will get the answer same. That means 6. In both left hand side and right hand side, you will get the same answer. That is 6. This property is called associative property. Now next is multiplicative identity and inverse. Like additive inverse, here is also multiplicative inverse. And additive identity same as multiplicative identity. But in additive identity, 0 is the additive identity. In that we are adding, but in multiplicative identity we are taking the multiplication. See the meaning of multiplicative. Multiplicative means multiplication. So multiplicative identity is, it is a number which when multiplied by any integer does not change the value of that integer, that means that number. Which number should be it is? Obviously 1, because if you multiply 1 by any number, you will get the number same as it is. That means A multiplied by 1 or 1 multiplied by A is same as A. For example, if you multiply 2 with 1, what will happen? You will get the answer 2 as it is. If you multiply 1 by 2, you will get the same answer 2. That means 1 is multiplicative identity. Now see the second, multiplicative inverse. Inverse, it is a number which on multiplying with the integer gives multiplicative identity. That means 1 as the answer. See the definition, a number which on multiplying with the integer, that means we have to multiply an integer by an integer so that you will get the answer 1. That means multiplicative inverse of an integer A is nothing but its reciprocal. That means if A multiply by 1 upon A, you will get the answer 1. Or 1 by A multiply by A, AA will get cancelled, so you will get the answer 1. That means a reciprocal is inverse of the integer A. So multiplicative inverse of 1 is 1 itself, because if 1 is multiplied by 1, you will get the answer 1. And multiplicative inverse of minus 1 is minus 1 itself, because if you multiply minus 1 by minus 1, you will get the answer 1. See the example, 2 multiplied by 1 by 2 is same as 1 by 2 multiplied by 2. That means if you multiply 2 with 1 by 2, 2 will get cancelled and you will get the answer 1. So 2 is multiplicative inverse of 1 by 2, and 1 by 2 is multiplicative inverse of 2. Now I will show you the another example. That means, for example, 4. We have to multiply 4 by a number such that you will get the answer 1. Which number should be we have to multiply with 4? The answer should be 1 upon 4. If you multiply 4 with 1 upon 4, you will get the answer 1, because 4 and this 4 will get cancelled. So 1 upon 4 is multiplicative inverse of 4, and 4 is multiplicative inverse of 1 by 4. Now see the second example, 6. Which number should we multiply 6 so that you will get the answer 1? Which number it will be? It will be 1 upon 6, because 6 and this 6 will get cancelled. 6 ones are 6, 6 ones are 6. That means 1 multiplied by 1, you will get the answer 1. So 1 upon 6 is the multiplicative inverse of 6, and 6 is multiplicative inverse of 1 upon 6. I will give you some numbers. You have to find the multiplicative inverse of that number. First number is 1 upon 3. Find the multiplicative inverse of 1 upon 3. Second is 4 upon 5. Now see here, 4 upon 5. How you will find this number? I will give one more example, that is 2 upon 3. 2 upon 3. Which number should be multiplied 2 upon 3 so you will get the answer 1? Now take the reciprocal of this number will be, that means denominator will become numerator and numerator will become denominator. Now in this, which one is the numerator? Numerator is 2 and denominator is 3. So take the numerator, replace the numerator with denominator and denominator with numerator. That means the reciprocal of this number will be 3 upon 2. Now see, these 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2, 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3. So you will get the whole answer as 1. That means 3 by 2 is multiplicative inverse of 2 by 3, or 2 by 3 is multiplicative inverse of 3 by 2. So you will get the idea for 4 upon 5. find the multiplicative inverse of these two numbers. Understand this thing? Till this we have seen the multiplicative identity and inverse. Now next is last one, distributive property of integers. In distributive property, take three numbers, three integers. If a, b and c are three integers, then a multiply by in bracket b plus c is equals to a multiply by b plus a multiply by c. That means we have to expand the left hand side, so you will get the right hand side. See the example, 2 multiply by in bracket 3 plus 4, which is equals to in bracket 2 multiply by 3 plus in bracket 2 multiply by 4. Only we have to expand the brackets, you will get the distributive property. See, left hand side is equals to right hand side. If we take the addition first and then after multiplication, you will get the same answer. Or take the multiplication first and after that take the addition, you will get the same answer. Now see left hand side, 2 multiply by in bracket 3 plus 4. First we have to solve the bracket. In bracket addition is there, that means 3 plus 4 will be 7, and outside the bracket 2 is with multiplication. Now take the multiplication, 7 to the 14. So left hand side gives 14. And see the right hand side, first bracket, first preference is for brackets, okay? Now first solve the bracket, 3 multiply by 2, you will get the answer 6, addition sign is there, and after that, now in this 2 multiply by 4, now take 2 multiplication with 4 will be 8. 6 plus 8, you will get the answer 14. Now see, both the left hand side and right hand sides are equal. This is distributive property. Now I will give you one more example. Now this is the second example. 4 multiply by 3 plus 2 and 4 multiplication with 3 plus 4 multiplication with 2. Both the equations we have to show, these two equations are equal. We have to show this equality. Now see here, first 4, keep 4 as it is because we have to solve first bracket. Now 4 multiplication, 3 plus 2, you will get the answer 5. 4 multiply by 5, 5 4s are 20. This side gives 20. Now see here, first we have to solve the bracket, after that take the addition. Now 4 multiply by 3, 4 multiply by 3, 12. Plus 4 multiply by 2, you will get the answer 8. Now 12 plus 8, you will get the answer 20. Now see, both the answers are equal. That means we have shown these two signs, these two equations are equal. That means this property, A multiply by B plus C, this is equals to, first take A multiplication with B, give the bracket, then give the sign of this one, that means plus sign, and after that A multiplication with C, give the bracket, A multiply by C. This property is called distributive property. Understand this thing?